Reposing Lag Bomer, we'd like very much to show you tables we did with Professor Aralik about Lag Bomer. All of them are from our book with Professor Aralik, Bible Code and Kabbalah. Lag Bomer definitely very big part in Kabbalah. So let us see. As you see here, the first page right, of our book. And in this introduction, Professor Aralik really writes the following. Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai's soul is in a constant state of elevation. Indeed, it reaches the ultimate domain of the infinite light, which receives the great contraction, tzimtzumim, libu, that is why the light of his holy accomplishment, especially really, shines each year on his yortzeit, Lag BaOmer. So therefore, we did quite interesting tables, and clearly shows connection of the option by Yochai, which is in abbreviation, Rashbi, yeah, this is the famous way that is known. So we have here interesting table, a table which was done by Professor Aralik. And this is a table in which you see Lag BaOmer, Rashbi, the Rashbi. So, about it, Professor Aralik writes, the function of Torah is to open an entrance to this hidden light, which is the all-inclusive primordial good. In the contents of Torah, the light is called the light of Torah. The light of Torah and the light of Lag BaOmer are the same light. So we see definitely. There is another interesting table which have also interesting words which I found. And this is really the words light of Torah and Lag BaOmer. This is exactly the idea that light of Torah shines off Lag BaOmer. So you can see it. Very interesting, Lag BaOmer. Oh, no, sorry, this is the previous one. And this one is this one, yeah. So, this what you see here is the following. You see here the word, or Torah, light of Torah, in Lag BaOmer, yeah. So, this is interesting table. It clearly shows this idea. And on this, Professor Aralik writes in the book, yeah, the following. Rabbi Gleason noticed that there is an extension to Lag BaOmer. The extension is your light, thus forming the phrase your light of Lag BaOmer. Very interesting phenomena. Then we can go into some other examples. So this is the next page, quite long one. Here you have very interesting idea because it has to do with Kabbalah. You have the light of Torah, and Lag BaOmer, light, Kaf, the letter Kaf. So, light of the Kaf, what is Kaf? Kaf, according to our sages, represents the Keter, the crown, which is exactly the hidden light that we have in Lag BaOmer. So it is very interesting that you have a quite long sentence, very significant, which says, Belag BaOmer, on Lag BaOmer, the light of the Kaf of the crown, which is the hidden light, and then, amazingly, in the table itself, you see, oh, Torah, the light of Torah. Very, very significant table, no doubt. You see here, our Torah, and here, very long sentence, as you can see, very long sentence. We said, Belag Baomer, in Lag Baomer, light of the crown. And which kind of light it is? Our Torah. Very, very interesting, significant table from this idea. From this light, Professor Aralik, by the merit of engaging in this light of Torah, that Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai makes near, may this light of Torah keep us and our children until it blossoms as the revealed light of the righteous Messiah, the light of the anointed King. So very interesting table, which clearly shows that in Lag BaOmer we have such kind of the hidden light of the crown, which is the highest sphere. Going more into this book, yeah, we brought very interesting ideas on Lag BaOmer. This is really one of them, which says the following. Shimon Bar Yochai and Meron. Now we know quite well about Meron. Unfortunately, this year you cannot have the hundreds of thousands of people there. So about this, Professor Ali Kroyd, there is a spark inside Jewish heart that burst into flame and on Lag BaOmer. On the eve of Lag BaOmer, tens of thousands of people begin to stream from all over to Meron, the burial place of Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai. The steady influx continues throughout the night and continues uninterrupted during the following day. There is such a magical feeling of unity in the endless procession of Jews coming and going on Meron, on Lag BaOmer, especially. We identify with Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai and Meron. So it is very interesting what Professor Aralik brings out, that something is awakened in Jewish art that draw thousands of Meron over every year, over quarter a million people visited Meron on Lag BaOmer this past year, what a while ago. This motivated the study using the key words Lag BaOmer, Rashbi, and Meron. We set up a study. This is what he said, like normally analyzing the table. And this is what he makes from this table. This makes a total of four combinations. Now this is exactly what it is. And then what Maury says about, yeah, this is another finding of Professor Aralik, Lag BaOmer, Rashbi, and Meron. Yeah, you can see Lag BaOmer, Rashbi, and Meron. Yeah, you can see the table. Yeah, Lag BaOmer, Meron, Rashbi and Meron. This is the connection of these places. Then, very, very interesting, significant table. I mean, interesting one. And this is also interesting words of Professor Aralik about Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai, which says Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai composed the Zohar. It is the most central of Jewish Kabbalah text. Zohar literally means radiance or splendor. Its extended meaning is enlightenment. The Zohar mystical explains the inner meaning of Torah and motivates those who study it to live a Torah true life and bring themselves closer to God. Topics discussed in the Zohar include God, the Sefirot, the Shekhinah, the soul, the good and evil inclinations, humanity, sin, death, mystical prayer, and the repairing of the universe. L'Ag B'Omer is a day on which Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai revealed some of the deepest teachings of the Zohar. It is also the day on which he died. The teachings in the Zohar are like fire, for the Zohar teaches that everything we see in the physical world also has a spiritual counterpart dimension that can also be perceived, but the eyes that see it are not our physical eyes. When a person gets a glimpse of the spiritual dimension of what he sees, he begins to perceive the depths of holiness that surrounds him in the world. This brings the person to another level of consciousness, a higher level of appreciation for all that God has created. Rabbi Daniel Baron Riches teaches, L'Ag B'Omer enables us to look deeper and to hear the ever-present broadcast of the creation. The flames of L'Ag B'Omer call to us and whisper that there is more to every person and every object than meets the eye, that one should never give up, even if it looks hopeless. Look behind the superficial and acknowledge deeper realms of existence, embrace worlds that we cannot see or touch, but which are every bit as real as the one in which we live. On L'Ag B'Omer, we light bonfires. We participate in ecstatic dancing. We study Zohar and other mystical writing in the memory of the luminary of Jewish mysticism, Shimon Bar Yochai. So interesting, and I see it very, very insignificant, table in his teaching, yeah. So here you have the word Shimon Bar Yochai, very interesting. And you have Shimon and Rashbi. Very interesting table. And in fact, it was found, part of it was Professor Reeves, part of it Professor Aralik. Very interesting. And let us see now what Professor Aralik found. Yeah. And this is what he found. Very interesting. Found here the name Shimon Bar Shimon, next to it Bar Yochai, and Rashbi. So again, very interesting connection of Shimon Bar Yochai. This is Shimon Bar Yochai and Rashbi. Again, clear connection of Shimon Bar Yochai and the Rashbi. Yeah, this one is also interesting. As you will see just now, in the table, some more verse, in fact, many more one, and a lot of verse. I have to tell you before what you have here. Shimon bar Yochai. In fact, we have Shimon and his father Yochai. Gila revealed the lights in Lag BaOmer. The Zohar and light of the holiday. Interesting, coming here. This is what I found. So let us see the table, got a lot of verse here. Yeah. So we have here, as we heard the verse in Lag BaOmer, the lights were revealed by Shimon bar Yochai, Shimon, the son of Yochai. And then the lights were revealed in this day. And as Professor Alich says here, very interesting, says about the connection of Shimon bar Yochai to Rabbi Akiva. So he says Rabbi Shimon bar Yochai was a disciple of Rabbi Akiva. He is known also as Rashbi from the first letter of his full name. After Rabbi Akiva was put to death by the Romans for studying Torah, Rabbi Shimon bar Yochai publicly condemned really the Romans for their cruelty and was himself sentenced to death. Together with his son Rabbi Eliezer, he went into hiding in a cave in the mountains of Pekin, according to one proverb. In the Galilee, where they stayed for all together for 13 years. During the 13 years in seclusion, Shimon bar Yochai wrote the Zohar. The table that we are going to see just now, shown below, was found by Professor Rips. We included it because of its interest and development of our time, of our theme. The table by itself is not so statistically, but definitely the teachings are very, very important. So let us see now what Professor Rips found. And this table is Shimon ben Yochai in the Yerushalmi Talmud, not Bar Yochai, which is Aramaic, but ben Yochai, son of Yochai. So you have Shimon ben Yochai, you have the Kabbalah definitely, you have Rashbi and the Zohar. And this was finding by Professor Rips. So let us see this table, very interesting table. You can see it. Yeah, you have the verse on top. And this is what it says, yeah? Shimon ben Yochai, Rashbi the Zohar. Very, very interesting table. And this is what Professor Alich said about this table, which was found by Professor Rips. And then some addition to this. So, altogether, a lot of material written by Professor Alich about Kabbalah, about Lag BaOmer. And this is an interesting table which I found, in which you have Zohar, Kabbalah in one sentence, and down in green you have the code, the Bible code, clearly connection with Kabbalah and Zohar, because this would see just now. And it's interesting what Professor Alich writes. The 16th century Kabbalist Rabbi Isaac ben Solomon Luria revolutionized the study of Jewish mysticism through Kabbalah. He had the gift to explore the innermost depths of the Zohar. His disciple Rav Chaim Vital wrote down his teaching, which have come to be known as Luranic Kabbalah. In this table, we take his name, Isaac Luria, and pair of this with Zohar and Kabbalah. The problem that a table has compact as the, this one, the, would rise in the ELS, I mean ELS is equal letters sequence, random, placement, monkey text, population is 9.5 to under 1,000. I mean very, very significant table. And this is definitely about Rabbi Isaac Luria, as you can see here. This here is the words Zohar Kabbalah and Yitzhak Luria, by the Luria. And this is definitely a very significant table, 9.5. And then Professor Alek again explained beautifully the Kabbalah Zohar Isaac Luria table was a development found by Professor Rips to understand the significance of this development. One must understand the four different miluim of the Ter Agamenes. It means the names of God, the full letters of name of God, the divine name. One way of spelling out the divine name is the Gematria of 72, and this is the divine name as manifested in the world of emanation. Who dominant, which is called very famous one, this is the word of emanation, whose dominant is the Sphira, the Sefer of Chokhmah. Another way of spelling the divine God is 45. This is the divine name as manifest in the world of formation, whose dominant and Sephira is Tiferet, glory. So very interesting in this book, Professor Rips explained beautifully. It is long, so we'll not read it. But he explained exactly what we see in the table and how it fits beautifully with Kabbalah. This is additional table. Continuation of what I found about Isaac Luria and Kabbalah and the Zohar. And in this table, we'll have this verse. So the verse that are in this table, in the long line, is Isaac Luria, Ari, Zohar, Kabbalah, and then the divine name of God, 45, which is Ma, and clarifies, Bill clarified in the vessel, the divine name of God, 72. So all this here in this table, yeah, from the bottom in blue, my verbally, this name of God, which will clarify the vessel, will bring to 72. And again, all this of Isaac Luria, the Zohar and Kabbalah, and even his name, Ari. Now, definitely this is idea which is, one can say, the most important in Kabbalah. Yeah, because we have a concept which is called the Shvirat HaKelim, the breaking of the vessels, because of a lot of light, whatever it is. Very difficult, definitely, ideas to learn about it in Sraim and so on. But the main idea is that there is a name of God, 45, which rectified this, and the world was created. So, very interesting and really worthwhile reading about it in this book, Bible Code and Kabbalah, The Secret of Creation, composed by Rabbi Glazerson and Professor Robert Halik. So, a lot more in this book about Kabbalah, what it means exactly, Kabbalah Torah. The famous one is this one, which Professor Rips found is edition of mine, which have the word He who recherches God's merited light of secret, and their codes will reconstruct Kabbalah. It means more explanation about Kabbalah. And this what Professor Aralik writes, he says the following. Some time after the above table was discovered, it was examined more closely and additional extensions were found. Kabbalah was extended to reconstruct Kabbalah, recounting codes was extended to he who researches code merited. Code was extended to the R codes. It's an amazing table. So the second part of this table is already to do with Shavuot, Kabbalah Torah. And this mitzvah we do later. But as I said, beautiful explanation by Professor Aralik Bart Lag Baomer, Rav Shmuel Bar Yochai. And definitely good introduction to Lag Baomer. Yeah. Beautiful picture, yeah, on about the festival in Meron. So, as I said, one can get this book in my site, Rabbi Glazerson, Glazerson.com, or in Amazon.com. So, as I said, that kind of introduction to Lag BaOmer, which happened Saturday night, unfortunately, not in Meron, but in different places, we celebrate this very enlightened day. So, let us have really a good Lag BaOmer, and as we said, normally inspiration of this Lag BaOmer, and enlightened day, no doubt. Hoping that Messiah is written, you know, quite famous, that in the Zohar we have a very famous part which says, God says to Rav Shmuel Bar Yochai, in the merit of studying, learning, the Zohar will have redemption of Messiah. No? This is what we need urgently now. So it's worth while really learning with ideas as much as one can. So really, as he said, we are really approaching very important and interesting that it is the Shabbos, which is just before Lag BaOmer. So it looks like that we need the Shabbos to help us to get much more light in Lag BaOmer, because Shabbos itself is in Kabbalah. The Shabbos is a time of studying Kabbalah, secrets of the Torah. And there is great light on Shabbat, so this light will bring us to the light of Lag BaOmer, no doubt that altogether this Lag BaOmer will have great enlightenment.